Plaintiff Mia Campbell says the defendant is her little brother, and he spends all of his money on his clothes, shoes, and hair. Mia claims everyone in her family spoils the defendant and enables his spending habits. But she's suing him today for the balance due on a rental car. Defendant Quentin Campbell says he and Mia were really close growing up, but now she likes to flirt with his friends. Quentin insists he never knew he owed a balance on the rental car.
Start with you.
This is my baby brother. I'll do anything for my brother. But he's like into materialistic things. He care about his clothes, his shoes, his hair. He's carefree. Like, he likes to party. He does his own thing. He no responsibilities, and that's fine.
Who pays for all these things?
Everybody.
He doesn't work?
You don't work?
That's not true, Your Honor. I work, yeah.
Okay. So why does everyone else have to pay if he works?
I mean, he works, but he's spoiled also. Like, he can get anything out of anybody because he's the baby.
Even though he works?
Yeah.
All right, well, y'all the suckers. I don't blame you. I do the same thing. Yeah, I work well. Can I get something?
I mean, if I had it.
Good enough. Go ahead.
He's no responsibilities. He goes on about his daily routine.
Yeah, but that's what it means to be spoiled. You get everything you need. You don't have to have any responsibilities. You got suckers who give you everything you want.
True, but he's into his fashion. I can guarantee you, if he steps from behind the podium, his shoes matches everything that he has on right now. Like, you know.
Hey, that's good. How about you?
Me? Oh no, My whole outfit is okay, no more than $50.
Right, because you give all your money to him to buy nice things. That's a good setup you got, Doc. I need a sister like you.
No, it's because I'm a student and I take care of myself. I'm the oldest, so I have all the responsibilities.
Where are you a student at?
I'm enrolled in Chicago State. I just graduated from Illinois Center for Broadcasting past September.
Yeah, what do you want to do?
Start my own radio station. I'm going to start off slow, do an online radio station, and hopefully branch off and do my own
thing. All right, so how are you going to be paid initially?
I'm going to work.
Oh, okay. Let's start there. Work what type of job?
I'm going to school for business and marketing, so take over somebody else's corporation and build up.
You're
going to
take over a company time you finish college.
Yes!
Where are you going to get the money to take over a company?
I'm going to save every penny that I get,
build it on my credit so I can get in loans.
I was working, but I'm not working now.
Right, but now, so?
My little twos and fews, do hair, babysit. I do some of everything.
Just Doing hair and babysitting is going to give you enough money to take over somebody's company.
I thought that's what you said. No, I put my money to the side in a savings account, let it double up, and
so when do you intend? When do you intend to take over somebody's corporation?
As soon as I get another internship and I graduate from college.
Okay. I think like most people who graduate from college, you're going to have to get a job and work that job, hopefully in your field, and get experience in your field before you can talk about buying somebody's company in your field.
I do freelance work in my field right now.
Good enough. You don't have to take my advice or my insight. Go ahead. Buy your big corporation off of babysitting money. Good enough. I don't know what I'm talking about. I just got here by luck. Sir, you want to tell me about yourself?
She my big sister. I love her to death. She do a little bit of stuff. I mean, I ain't going to say a lot. Not how she put trying to put me out here like that. I ain't going to say they do everything for me. I get out here and I do it for myself. I buy anything I want for myself.
Good. Where you work?
My granddaddy got a barbershop. I just do a little work up in there for him. That's about it.
And that affords you the ability to buy what you want.
I mean, I don't really want too much of nothing, but like little clothes.
But whatever it is you want, you buy it yourself.
Yeah, and I buy
based
myself.
Based on working?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
She's the only girl out of four children, you know. Me, my brother, and her is right up under each other. I'm 24, she 20. My other brother 25, she 26. So we always stuck around each other when we was coming up or whatever. So she was always trying to run up behind us, be with us, and we boys, so we kicking around a lot of guys all the time. And you know, I wouldn't want my sister to be hanging around me and my guys. She always around kicking it. So as we grew up and we got older, I'd be bringing over my friends over. She real flirtatious. I don't like that. I don't like my friends being up in my sister's face. She keep them smiling, keep them company, but this my company though. You know what I'm saying? I'm supposed to be doing that work, keeping them company and stuff like that. That's not her business to keep them company. She a knee freak too. I go over her house. I can't even walk on the carpet. Got to take my shoes off. Wear little foot booties around the house. Yana, I'm surprised she ain't wearing none right now. Yana, you see how clean your floor is? That's exactly how hers be. No trash, none of that. I take my coat off, sit it on her bed. Oh, nah, you
so
gotta move.
So she has her own place.
She, like back and forth, she'd be with me at my mother's house, and she'd be
at
my...
She'd be with you then, she'd be with her mother.
Right, well, yeah.
Because you stay with mama.
Yeah, I stay with mama. I'm mama's boy.
When are you gonna try and get your own place? Yeah, I thought you said you pay for everything you need.
I'm working on it. I had that apartment and a house and all that.
Well,
I ain't
no,
ready
that's
for
the number
it.
One need in
I
life.
I know, but I ain't.
So you don't pay for what you need. Your mama pay for what you need.
Well, I help out on rent now.
Oh, you help out?
Yes,
what
sir.
What percentage?
Yes, sir. What percentage? I say for about a month, I probably pay $150, $200 or something.
How much
like
you
that.
Think the rent is?
$1,200.
Okay. Just trying to establish the facts here while you're saying you take care of everything for yourself.
Well,
you don't.
All right,
mama do. All right, at some point, my man, you gotta take care of yourself. How far did you go in school?
Man, I finished high school, that was it.
Why didn't you go any further?
I always wanted my own thing, so I had just got a
like
job.
Her.
I had got a job and was working a little job, sad job, that's it.
We won't afford you to get your own place though.
That's something that I wasn't thinking about at the time.
You never thought about getting your own place?
I did, but I don't know how it's going to work out.
What do you mean you don't know how it's going to work out? You don't know how you're going to afford it? Is
yes,
that what
sir.
You mean?
Yes.
You're going to get a skill or an education, and then you use that to get a job that'll afford you the amount of money to take care of yourself. So we don't want you staying with mama all your life. Mama need a break.
I know.
You're about 20, how old are you, 24?
24,
give
yes.
mama a break. Don't let her pay off. Give mama a break. Your sister's a good example. She's ambitious, super ambitious. Nonetheless, she at least is ambitious. But let's get to the rental car you're suing him about.
He got it on the April 26th. His mm-hmm. birthday was on the 27th. He kept it for an extra week. So the additional charges and the overages, it equaled out to $257.
All right, sir.
Okay, Your Honor. I had the car and I did keep it for a time period that I wasn't supposed to keep it for, but when I had initially took the car back, and when I had took the car back, I wasn't aware that I had owed her any money. I want to say the next day, I got a phone call from my sister talking about I owe her like almost $300, and it had me lost, because I ain't know how could I owe you $300 if I just came and paid you after I had the car.
Why do you think she's suing you if you already paid her?
She probably just wants some money, Your Honor. I don't know what she did with. I don't know what she did with the money, Your Honor. I just know
I was
that,
wondering why she's suing you, making this up.
I'm trying to see the same thing, Your Honor.
Okay.
I got a phone call mm-hmm. saying
I believe she's doing it because you owe her.
You think so?
Yeah.
She never showed it. She
okay,
never
she
showed,
never
me
showed it. All right, that's what the problem is. Take a look. All right? You see it? Now pay her. Judgment for the plaintiff. Have a good day.
Man, that's crazy, man. I just happy it's all over. I love my sister. I'm mad that we had to go through all this. So
I love my brother, and it's not going to change. And if he asks me to do something again, I'm still going to do it.